One of the biggest reasons that new associates may fail to get to yes with client compliance is that they don't take the time to engage the client, to get to know them, and to develop rapport and trust with the client. The way to do that, the way to gain the client's trust, is to start your appointments simply getting to know the client. So after you introduce yourself and acknowledge the pet, take a few moments, even up to 5 moments or more, and simply get to know the client and the pet. And the best way to do this is to ask open-ended questions. I recommend starting appointments with a broad open-ended question such as, "Tell me how Jake's been doing the last 9 months since we saw him," or "Tell me a little bit about Bella and how she integrates into your family and how you all spend your time together." The idea is you're inviting the client to tell you about their pet and their life with this pet. Now, you don't have to have the questions just be about the pet, because the idea is to engage the client. So ask open-ended questions to the client as well, simply about them and their lives. And one of the best tips I can give you is to ask your coworkers about this client. Say, "Tell me, what do you know about this client that might help me develop rapport with them?" So maybe your coworkers would tell you, "Well, this client just came back from a trip to Europe. This is a client who likes to garden. Maybe the client has a son that's in soccer." So then during the course of the appointment, you could say, "Gosh, I heard your son's on the varsity soccer team. Tell me how he's doing this year." Remember, the client engagement process extends throughout the entire appointment. So when you get to the time when you're going to make recommendations to the client, rather than launching into what I call doctor lecture mode, stop and ask the client some open-ended questions at that point as well. So let's say, for example, you were going to ask the client or going to talk to the client about senior pet food because you know the dog is not on a good food. Rather than launching into a client education piece about why the dog needs to be on senior food, instead, you would look at the client and assess their knowledge by saying, "Tell me what you know about senior pet food." Because clients will be more receptive to your recommendation if you tailor your message to them. Tailor the message based on what their knowledge base is at that point, but also based on how willing they are to receive the message. Because the concept is you want the client to be a partner in care. You don't want to just be directional at them. So you want to engage them in the process. You want to develop trust and rapport. Client engagement has to come before you simply make recommendations. If you follow that process, you'll get to yes with your clients and client compliance will go up.